Good evening, everyone. Today we have listening session one, and our trainer for today is Mr. Shafiq Mohammed. These are a few instructions for you all. Make sure you have stable internet connection and a noise-free environment, for which we recommend you to use your earphones for the best experience. Moreover, respect your instructor, your classmates, and yourself. Be respectful and professional, and do not write anything inappropriate in the chat box. Moving ahead, you have these free, bronze, silver, and gold memberships with some additional features as displayed on the screen. So for getting yourselves to upgrade to this, any of these memberships, you can directly go on the website of Ubergrad and get yourselves upgraded there. Moreover, we have free profile evaluation, which is done by our experts, which consists of university shortlisting, course recommendations, country recommendations, which are made according to a student's future aspirations, course of study, academic profile, recommendations, academic strengths, and requirements. We also have recommendations report, which is customized for the students according to their profile and requirements. And we have doubt clearance regarding the study abroad process, which consists of shortlisting applications, scholarships, etc. Moving ahead, we have these free GRE and Duolingo classes, which goes on every week. So firstly, we have free GRE live classes, which goes on from Monday to Friday, 8:30 to 9:30. It's a 2-month course. Then we have free live Duolingo classes, which goes from Monday to Friday, 6:30 to 7:30. It's a 2-week course. So for getting yourselves enrolled for any of these two, you can directly go on the website of Ubergrad and get yourselves enrolled there. Moving ahead, we also have one-to-one IELTS classes, that is, that happens when you get the gold membership, when you get yourselves upgraded to the gold membership. So it is just for ₹5,999, and you get benefits like 20 hours live classes, class recordings, daily class worksheets, 10 plus sessional tests, 5 full length mocks. So it's a very good opportunity for you all, as you get all these facilities one-to-one with the experts, and it's just for a very minimal amount of ₹5,999. So in order to avail this, you can send in your details in the chat box and our team will get into contact with you. Moving ahead, we have these achievements of the students who got themselves enrolled at Ubergrad. Now I'll quickly show you the website of Ubergrad. So this is the website of Ubergrad, that is ubergrad.com. Now over here, we have a lot of information related to the various countries, the universities, courses, and the examinations. So you can explore a lot of information that's already there on the website of Ubergrad. Now we also have free profile evaluation. Now under free profile evaluation, as you can see, it is done by our experts. So you can book your slots according to your preferable time and date. If you have like any doubts related to anything, you can just book your slots over here on this portal, and whatever discussions you want to have with the experts in order to clear your doubt, you can get it over here. Now moving ahead, we also have talk to a counselor option, as I mentioned before, and we have AI country recommendations, AI course recommendations, and some test preparation stores consisting of live IELTS, live GRE, live Duolingo classes, and we have some additional services for the students, consisting of education loans, forex card, accommodation, international SIM, US credit card, US bank account, etc. And we also have some blogs which have been uploaded on the website. Go on the website of Ubergrad. Go on to your name, My Test Preparation. Go on to IELTS Academic Comprehensive Live Classes course. On clicking on that particular option, it will take you to this window. Now over here, you can see that we have four modules under IELTS, that is listening, reading, speaking, and writing. So the recordings of all the modules and the sessions that have been conducted under those modules are available to you, you here. So for example, you want to access the recording of listening session one. So directly go on listening, go on day one. Then the first option would be the access to the handouts of that particular module and the session. And the last recording would be the current recording. So when I clicked on the last one, it has, all right. So today we have the listening session. So you can access the yesterday's, not yesterday's, but the previous recording of the listening that has been taken place on 13th of November. So like in the same way, you can access the recordings, the handouts of all the other sessions and the modules. And after you complete each module, the sessional test of that particular module is also available to you over here itself. And so you can just practice the sessional test that, that are available to you over here. And also, I'll share you the Telegram channel link in the chat. So you can join the Telegram channel, and a lot of mock tests are available to you there as well. So you can access those mock tests as well and practice a lot about it. Now, there's also a small surprise for you guys, which I'll be sharing at the end of the session. So for that surprise, just stay tuned till the end of the session, and you'll get to know about the surprise that's waiting for you. So now I'll hand over the session to our trainer for today, Mr. Shafiq Mohammed. So, sir, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, hi guys, very good evening. So let me switch on my camera too. Okay, I hope you can all see me now. Okay, those who are raising the hands, I want you to, you know, type it in the chat box if you have any questions. Okay, yes, so please type it in the chat box. Even either ma'am or I will be answering those. Okay, so let me quickly share the screen. And by the way, my name is Mohammed Shafiq. You can call me Shafiq. Okay, I'm your IELTS trainer today. And yes, so we'll be extensively talking about listening today. Okay, so it's one of the modules. Let me also join through my mobile so that I can see your this too. Just give me one sec. Okay, great. So I can also see your messages now. If you want to type anything, you can type it over there. Okay. Okay, great, guys. So as you can see, my students are listening day to day. Okay. And we have four modules, which are listening, reading, writing, and speaking. What are those four modules? Listening, reading, writing, and speaking. These are the four modules in IELTS, and each day you will be getting this. I mean, each week we'll be completing one module. For example, this week we are going to do listening, and next week you're going to do reading, then writing and speaking. Okay, so yes, 1 week, one module we are going to cover. So let's quickly jump into the session. Okay, so what is listening all about? Listening is all about listening to an audio or set of audios and answering the questions in the paper or computer. So by now you would have researched about the ways to write IELTS, right? So there are two ways to write IELTS. One is computer-based test, which is called as CBT, computer-based test, CBT, okay? And another one is paper-based test. So both the ways of attempting the IELTS are effective. Those who are typing, people say that I'll go for CBT. It's not only about typing, okay? So no need to be a shorthand or the fastest typing on the keyboard. No, that's not required. So nowadays, I think everyone uses a computer. Everyone uses, a laptop. So I believe typing 400 words for writing in 1 hour is not a great deal for you, right? So, and by the way, by the end of the third week or after completing the writing module with us, you yourself will, discover whether to write CBT, which is computer-based test, or paper-based test. So don't worry about it. And both the criterias are one and the same for listening, reading, and writing, all the modules, okay? So only the thing is the interface changes. Interface is nothing but paper-based. You'll be writing with your pencil on the paper physically. And obviously, CBT is, you need to type it. The AI will actually, take the answers and all. And definitely AI will give you the score. But the score will not come SAP. The only difference in paper-based to computer-based is the entire band scores will come little earlier in computer-based, obviously AI-based, right? So within four to five days, for example, you have written your exam today. By before Monday itself, you'll get your score. But in paper-based test, it will take 13 days. On your 13th day, for example, now you have written the test, or today you have written the test. And after 13th day, or on 13th day, from today onwards, yes, you'll get it. Okay. So mostly I've seen, people getting the score mostly for paper-based test. And computer-based test, every week there will be a revealing of the scores. So there is no particular limit. Okay, how many times I need to give the examination, or how many times can I give the examination to get my perfect score? So n number of times. But the thing is, 16,500 or the amount you pay for the examination is that is what you need to pay. But paper-based test, I think you can do only two times in a month, because you need to wait for 13 to 14 days, then you need to book the test. Okay. So after that also, depending upon the availability of the test, you need to book for paper-based test. But computer-based test, I think it is round the clock available. All you need to do is 2 weeks before, you need to check which date you want to go, and you can book it. Not a big deal. Okay. So yes, listening. So listening is like listening to an audio and answering it in the paper or computer. Okay. So what are these audios all about? These audios are all general, things which, a conversation, a monologue, okay, which takes place in these audios. So mostly we have four sections here. We have four audios, four different recordings. For example, okay, obviously four different recordings. First recording will be a conversation between two people, and that will go on, that entire section will go on with that recording, and you have to answer 10 questions. And second recording, again, it will be a monologue, where monologue is nothing but one person speaking, or one person uttering something or giving some information. That is called monologue. That will be second section, where again, you'll be answering 10 more questions. And third, again, 10 questions. It will be a conversation between, now this time, two or more people. Okay? more than 2 to 3 people will be in this conversation for the third section. Then after third section, then answering for 10 questions, then another 10 questions for section 4. And it will be a monologue that one person will be uttering something, and you need to listen and answer it simultaneously. So mostly, test takers ask me, sir, do I need to listen to the entire audio after the audio finishes off? Then I need to answer. No, you need to simultaneously, means parallelly, you need to answer. So once the recording finishes, they go to second recording, that is second section. The entire second section recording and the matter and the conversation or the monologue, the topic will be different. You will forget everything. So you need to answer simultaneously. So that anyways, we will discover. So by the way, listening has 40 questions and 4 sections. So it is divided into 4 into 10. Okay. So both good to know information is both academic and general. Mostly you're writing academic, right? Those who are students will go for those who want to, study abroad. Obviously, they'll do academic IELTS. General IELTS is what, when once they complete their 2 years or there, again, IELTS will not leave you. Believe me, again, you have to give IELTS and then you will get a job or a PR or a whatever. Okay. So mostly academic IELTS, but good to know information is both are one and the same for listening. Okay. Yes. So till here it is understood, right? 4 sections, 40 questions. And by the way, what is the time to complete this module? See, each and every module is given a set of time. So any guesses, what is the time to complete listening module? Can you please type it in the chat box, guys? Already Sai has typed, Sai Pila, Gangadhar. Yeah, Gangadhar Reddy has typed. Rohan has typed 3 minutes, sir. No. Varala, 50, no. Jahanavi Gupta, yes. It's 40 minutes, that is, yes, like Shubham has given, 30 plus 10. So Shubham, how do you know this? How do you know that it is 30 plus 10? Can you type it and tell me, like, where have you heard it from? Yes, Jahanavi, yes, 30 plus 10. Correct. Very good. So, yes, very good. From online resources, very good. So it's good that you always research for things, right? Yes. So it is 30 plus 10 instead of telling directly 40 minutes. Why we should say 30 plus 10 is 30 minutes is where the audio goes on, and simultaneously you will be writing in the question paper if you're doing a paper based test. And extra 10 minutes is given to jot down the answers in the answer sheet. Okay, if you are writing a paper based test. But even for CBT also, even for computer-based test also, even though you were typing when the entire audio goes on, after that, extra 10 minutes is given. Sir, why again we are not jotting down the answers in the answer sheet in the end? We don't have any other separate answer sheet for CBT, right? So why again 10 minutes? To check your answers, to go through your spellings, because it's an international English examination, obviously an English examination. You have to be good in spellings. No spelling mistakes, guys. No spelling errors. Okay? Because end of the day, it's an English examination. What is the full form of it? It is International English Language Testing System. Definitely, you have to follow all the criteria. And one of the criteria is spelling. Spelling mistakes you should not make. Okay? In listening. Then, yes. For online, okay. So any other doubts till here? Everything is understood, right? 40 questions, 4 sections, 40 minutes, audio goes on, and you need to simultaneously write the answers or type the answers. Okay. Yeah, Ashwin is asking CBT based paper. What is CBT based paper? Will be I provided with paper and pen to note down the answers. Okay, in CBT based test, you need to type directly in the blank itself. Okay, for example, let me show you one fill in the blank. Okay. Okay, for example, you need to type it here. If there is a blank here, you will directly type it in CBT. There's no other thing like you will write it on the paper, then you'll type it. No, you have to type it simultaneously. But rough paper will be given just to scribble down anything. Okay, for your thing. If we ask them to, what is it? Ravi Sharma is asking. If we ask them to pen and paper, will they provide us? No, you have to take your stationaries, guys. Yes, you have to take your stationaries, but rough paper will be provided, okay, to write down or scribble down something. But believe me, you should not waste any time in writing on the paper on CBT, at the time of CBT, because everything you need to work on the computer itself. Yes, sometimes some of the phone numbers and all, if you feel that okay, I need to write it sometimes, yes, you can, you will be getting the paper. Even pencil also they'll provide, but take your own stationaries. Take 2 to 3 pencils, 1 pen, okay, sharpener, eraser, these things. Take your own stationaries, paper will be provided. Okay, thank you. So let's quickly go back to our starting of the session. Yes, key points. Okay, before key points, I want you to tell band scores, right? We didn't discuss about band scores. So band scores are given in this way. It's very simple. For example, if you score 27 to 29, you'll get 6.5. If you score about 7 and 7 plus bands. So your target should be always, out of 40 questions, your target should always be 30 plus correct answers. That means so that you can score 7 plus bands. So you, sir, I need only 6 bands in every module. Why should I go for 7? Yes, that is true. But it is like, in our academics, if we score for, 90%, we'll stand somewhere around 85, right? 85 to 80. In the same way, always aim for higher score. Okay. And also, there is also this thing, right? If you score for higher, scoring like IELTS, if you get a higher band score, there are chances of getting good universities. Okay. But basically, to get into any country and any university, this is the required band score. No band less than 6, overall 6.5. And it changes according to the university to university. Okay. And course to course also. Okay. And these are the things. So your aim should be always 7 plus band. That means how much out of 40 questions? Your target should be 30 correct answers, 30 plus correct answers. That means you should be very, very, perfect enough that, yes, at least 7 correct answers in each section. 7, 3, 7, 4 is a 28, right? Obviously. So, first section will be easier. You can score easily 10. Okay. 10 plus 7 plus 7 plus maybe another fourth section, 8. So altogether, your standings above 30 correct answers. So you should make these kind of targets, okay, to achieve your desired band score. Okay, let's go further. So we have multiple choice questions, matchings, plan diagrams, form and labeling, flow chart, summary, sentence completion, short answer questions, classifications. We are going to do every type of question in this 1 week, guys. So please, I request you to stay tuned with me. It's not like, okay, you join today and after that, maybe day after tomorrow, you're going to join. No, you'll be missing things. So to have the flow, I want you to stay tuned with these in these 5 days. We only have 5 days, right? Okay, Monday to Friday. So these 5 days, if you stay tuned with the training, yes, definitely I'll be covering all the question types. Okay, yes. So quickly, we'll jump into the multiple choice type of questions. I want everyone to wear your headsets. Okay, so I'll give you 2 minutes for everyone Okay. So I want everyone to wear your headset and be ready. The reason is, in the examination, you will be given a, you know, authentic headset, you know, a big one. But when you practice, you know, at home, you have to use your earphones or earpiece, whatever you call it. Okay. Use your earpiece. Okay. I'm giving you 2 minutes. Meanwhile, let me answer this question. Hello, sir. Will you provide this PDF at the end? I think ma'am already posted this, you know, link for this thing. If not, she'll post soon. Okay. Don't worry about it. Okay. So as of now, till you get that link, just concentrate on the screen which you have. Okay. And listen to me. So we're going to do multiple choice questions. Is everyone ready with your headset? Please type yes or no fast. I want at least 20 SS. Then we'll start. The reason is, if you don't use your headset, you might not hear the recording clearly. And if you don't hear the recording clearly, definitely you'll make mistakes. Okay, I got my SS. Thank you, so many SS. Very good. Let's go. So the key points to remember here are, you will have to do multitasking, because sometimes when you are looking at the first question, the next question's answer also will be coming up. So you need to do duals. Okay, check two. You know, you have to have your, you know, you need to surround your eyesight with two questions. Okay, you need to be punching in two questions. But usually it will take little time to go to the next question. But sometimes to make you, you know, the examiner, to make you little, you know, hurry, this next answer would come. So you have to be little fast. And that only comes, that fastness, that, you know, that carefulness, that keen to get the, you know, the keyword or the answer word, that only comes with the practice, guys. Okay. So that is multitasking. And apart from that, examine the number of words are available in the response. That means read the instruction carefully, then answer. So sometimes if there are gaps or fill in the blanks, it will be written as no more than 2 words, no more than 3 words. So read things, whatever it is. Before you start the question, read the instruction. Then you'll understand it, what to do over there. Okay. Don't try to understand everything. IELTS will provide additional information. Obviously, some additional blah, blah, blah will be going on. But no need to understand, he's saying. But your mind, heart, soul, everything should be on the speakers, what they are speaking. Don't let your concentration go like this for a while. Who's sitting beside? Who is there watching the others? No. Don't do that in the examination, at least. So your concentration, your entire keenness should be on the question paper only, and the audio. Got it? Then look for the answers. Okay, these are the general things, you know, plurals and all. So you'll discover it. Spellings are very important. Obviously, I told you this, isn't it? And also the word limit. Is the instruction saying 1 word or 2 words? Okay, 3 words or a number, 1 word or a number. So those, once you start doing it, you'll get the answers. And also dollars. If dollars are there, yes, dollar symbols are there. Again, no need to write a dollar symbol. Okay, percentage symbols. You can use these symbols. Percentage symbol, dollar symbol, if it is not there in the question. Okay, if they have already given like dollar dash, then you'll write only 30.80, for example, the answer. No need to write again dollar symbol 30.80. If the dollar is given out there, you'll not write. If the percentage is given out there, you'll not write it. Okay, if PM is given out there in the question, you'll write only 1. Okay, these things, any which ways, you will discover. Let's do multiple choice questions. Okay. Someone is asking, on paper-based test, we need to write with pen or pencil. Yes. Pencil only. Guys, if it's paper-based test, you need to write it with pencil only. So take 2 to 3 pencils, sharpener, eraser. Okay, these things are very, very common. So pencil only. So the reason is, the best thing is, if you want to erase something, if you have written one spelling wrong or answer wrong while checking, so you can erase it and you can write it neatly, right? But if pen means, it will be scribbled up. But usually they ask you to write in pencil if it's a paper-based test. Okay, now, these are multiple choice questions. Let's discover once we go into the audio. So I'm playing the audio. Please listen to it.
You will hear a conversation between a student and a doctor at a student health center.
So what's your problem?
Well, recently I've been getting this pain here, just behind my eyes and in my forehead.
I see. Have you felt sick or dizzy at all, or vomited?
No, not at all. Though the pain is pretty intense sometimes.
And how's your health generally? Have you had any colds or flu recently?
I had a cold a couple of weeks ago, but that's gone. It was only a sniffle, really.
Good. Are you studying a lot? Are you getting enough sleep?
Yes, I'm studying quite a lot. I've got some exams coming up in December, but I'm making sure to sleep plenty.
What time do you go to bed?
Usually around 11. I sleep about 8.5 hours, and I'm up about 7:30, so I have time to go jogging for half an hour before going to the university at 9.
Very healthy. And has this pain kept you awake or stopped you jogging?
Yes, it makes getting to sleep harder. It's much worse at the end of the day. I hardly notice it in the morning.
What about food? Are you eating properly?
I think so. My girlfriend cooks my meals.
Right, and do you wear glasses?
No.
When did you last visit an optician?
I don't remember. When I was a child, I suppose.
Okay. Well, I think first you should get that done again, just to make sure it's not the cause. In the meantime, take an aspirin or two when you're in pain, and come and see me again in a week. Ask the receptionist to give you an appointment with the optician. He's here on Tuesday and Thursday morning.
Okay. So there is, you know, a small surprise for you. Another fourth question is there, which is based on this recording. I'll show you that question. And there, you need to choose. And here, you need to choose two options. Okay. So which of these things does doctor suggest Martin should do? So you need to choose two options from here. Before options, you need to choose only one, right? So here you need to choose two, but when it comes to this page, the audio, you know, will not, you know, play. So what you need to do is, can you take a pic of this, please? All of you, can you take a pic of this? I'll repeat the entire audio one more time. I know most of you didn't get it. Yes, take a screenshot of it. I'll tell you what to do. Take a screenshot of it. Okay, now again, I'll play the entire audio now, okay? So listen to it for the second time. But in the examination, the audio will play only once. But here, we are practicing. We can play n number of times because we need to get the hang of the listening, isn't it? How these native speakers speak. So definitely, I'm going to play it one more time. Please listen to it. And from 1, 2, 3, you need to choose only one option. Only for the fourth question, you need to choose two options. Remember this, okay? Yes.
You will hear a conversation between a student and a doctor at a student health center.
So what's your problem?
Well, recently I've been getting this pain here, just behind my eyes and in my forehead.
I see. Have you felt sick or dizzy at all, or vomited?
No, not at all. Though the pain is pretty intense sometimes.
And how's your health generally? Have you had any colds or flu recently?
I had a cold a couple of weeks ago, but that's gone. It was only a sniffle, really.
Good. Are you studying a lot? Are you getting enough sleep?
Yes, I'm studying quite a lot. I've got some exams coming up in December, but I'm making sure to sleep plenty.
What time do you go to bed?
Usually around 11. I sleep about 8.5 hours, and I'm up about 7:30, so I have time to go jogging for half an hour before going to the university at 9.
Very healthy. And has this pain kept you awake or stopped you jogging?
Yes, it makes getting to sleep harder. It's much worse at the end of the day. I hardly notice it in the morning.
What about food? Are you eating properly?
I think so. My girlfriend cooks my meals.
Right, and do you wear glasses?
Okay, now she started asking about the glasses and sight and everything, right? So here the audio goes on for the fourth question. Now, quickly, whatever the fourth question is, go there. I want you to, you have taken a pic, isn't it? I want you to go there and go. Okay, I'm playing the audio. You need to choose two options from the fourth question, okay?
No.
When did you last visit an optician?
I don't remember. When I was a child, I suppose.
Okay. Well, I think first you should get that done again, just to make sure it's not the cause. In the meantime, take an aspirin or two when you're in pain, and come and see me again in a week. Ask the receptionist to give you an appointment with the optician. He's here on Tuesday and Thursday morning.
Okay. Now I think you got it. So you'll type the answers in the chat box, guys, everyone. I want 100% participation from everyone, okay? For example, you will type 1, A, B, or C, one option, right? 1, 2, 3, okay? Then after the fourth one, you'll type two options, okay? So I want in the same message, don't type in different messages, okay? In the same message at a time, click go and send it to me in the chat box. Fast, I'm giving you 1 minute. Let's see who has given the right answer. I'll tell you the right answer, by the way, but I want your answers now. I want to see how many of you have given the right answer. Okay, Basha, ABC. Okay. Very good. Most of you guys have given the right answer. I'm still waiting for the answers. Does anyone wants me to repeat the audio? No, right? For the third time? Don't worry. This entire recording will be available by tomorrow. So don't worry about it. Even if you want to hear, you can hear it in tomorrow's thing. This will be available in our website, Ubergrad website. Okay, you're asking me to repeat, Jahanavi. You want me to repeat the audio for the fourth question, or you want me to show the fourth question? Which one is it? Jahanavi Gupta. Let's show the fourth question. Okay. Yeah, this is the fourth question. I asked you guys to take a pic, right? Yeah. Raj, it is fourth question. This is the fourth question, which is there on your screen. And you need to choose two options. Okay, guys. Now give me your answers. Everyone, I want everyone to give your answer. Please don't sit there like couch potatoes and just, listen. I want you to participate. Okay. Yes. Sorry, sir. My network got stuck then. Okay. No problem. I know. Technological errors or technological, the ways we are, we have to suffer sometimes. So no issues. Now that you got it, yes. So the first answer is A. He suffers from headaches. He says pain behind my eyes and forehead. Obviously, forehead and eyes belong to headache, right? That's common sense. So we need to use that, common sense common sense criteria. The reason is to get the answer, because he didn't say nausea. He didn't say infection. She asks, do you suffer from vomiting and all? No, he says no. Any infection? No. Any infection of kind? He says no. But He says he suffers from pain behind the eyes and forehead. Obviously, it is headache. We all know it, right? So, it is the paraphrasing. We need to catch it most of the time. Okay? So, because it won't be direct. Got it, guys? So, next. The answer is A for the first one. And second one, how many hours does Martin usually sleep each night? So, it is not less than 8. It is not more than 8 at all. He says, I sleep 8.5 hours and so, right? So 8.5 hours means definitely between 8 and 9. So this is the right choice for the thing which you have said, isn't it? Yes. So B as in boy, okay? Which is between 8 and 9 is the answer for the second one. Then third, which of these describes Martin's problem? So he says it is worse in the evening and at night. So he says something in the later part of the evening. I can see it is, the pain is quite intense, isn't it? So definitely it is C. Third one is C. C as in cat. Okay. Then fourth, we need to choose two options here. I'll tell you the options first. The first one is have his eyes tested. B. B is the right answer. She says, before meeting me, visit the optician. Optician means obviously he needs to get his eyes tested. Why do we meet an optician? To get the eyes tested, isn't it? And then have an aspirin. Have an aspirin means take some medicine. So both B as in boy and E as an elephant. Okay. B and E are the right answers. Okay. Any questions in this? Is it clear, guys, for everyone? Shall we go to the next question? Okay. Okay, we'll go to the next question.
First.
We'll do, yes, this one, third one. Okay. The sample question 2, you're going to practice on your own. Okay. Sample question 3. Okay. So I want you to again listen to it. Before I switch on the audio, before I turn on the audio, I want you to go through the questions. Okay. I'll give a half a minute to go through these questions. So here we only have 3 questions. There is no 4th question. Don't worry. Okay. Only 3 questions. I need you to choose only one option. And the answer should be A, B, or C, not the words. Okay, got it? Not the words in the thing. You need to choose only the letters. That is the reason. Read the instruction. Choose the correct letter. So when you are writing the answer in the answer sheet, mostly paper-based test, you will have to write only the letter, not the word. For example, for the first one, A, punctuality is correct. If you're writing A and both punctuality, you might not get a mark, or you only wrote punctuality, you might not get a mark. Please don't do that. You have to write only the letter for paper-based test. But computer-based test, you won't have the hassle. The reason is the drop-down will be there, A, B, C. You just need to choose the drop-down. Okay? Yes. So, let me play the audio.
Now, what is the nature of your complaint?
I'm phoning to complain about a flight I took recently. I always take certain measures to ensure that I will be comfortable. For example, I always pay the additional cost for extra legroom, and I always arrive punctually for the flight to make sure that I'm seated beneath an air conditioner. Unfortunately, I was disappointed to find that the air conditioning on the plane was broken, so I spent the entire flight in discomfort as it was too hot and the air was stuffy.
I see. I do apologize for this fault with the air conditioning. Now, while I have you on the phone, would you mind answering a short questionnaire regarding your recent flight?
Sure.
Okay, let's get started. What did you think of the food that was served to you during the flight?
I thought that it was inexpensive and quite delicious. However, I was still very hungry afterwards, as it was a very small portion and more of a snack. Providing a snack for lunch is not reasonable.
Okay, I have noted that down. What was your opinion of the quality of service that you received from our staff on board?
The staff was very helpful but each time I pressed the button to request service, it took a long time for a staff member to arrive. I found this frustrating, as there just weren't enough staff on board the flight to be able to serve all the customers.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much for answering those questions.
Okay, before you type in the answers in the answer, in the chat box, I'll try to actually repeat it one more time. Okay, those who didn't get it, please try the next time also. Okay. Yes.
Now, what is the nature of your complaint?
I'm phoning to complain about a flight I took recently. I always take certain measures to ensure that I will be comfortable. For example, I always pay the additional cost for extra legroom, and I always arrive punctually for the flight to make sure that I'm seated beneath an air conditioner. Unfortunately, I was disappointed to find that the air conditioning on the plane was broken, so I spent the entire flight in discomfort as it was too hot and the air was stuffy.
I see. I do apologize for this fault with the air conditioning. Now, while I have you on the phone, would you mind answering a short questionnaire regarding your recent flight?
Sure.
Okay, let's get started. What did you think of the food that was served to you during the flight?
I thought that it was inexpensive and quite delicious. However, I was still very hungry afterwards, as it was a very small portion and more of a snack. Providing a snack for lunch is not reasonable.
Okay. I have noted that down. What was your opinion of the quality of service that you received from our staff on board?
The staff was very helpful, but each time I pressed the button to request service, it took a long time for a staff member to arrive. I found this frustrating, as there just weren't enough staff on board the flight to be able to serve all the customers.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much for answering those questions.
That was nice, right? So I remember for the second answer. Okay, by the way, firstly, we'll discuss the answer for the first one. So most of you have typed the right answer, guys. Now, I want everyone to give your answers, the remaining people. Please give in your answers, all the three answers, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Please type in your answers, everyone. Why Jahnavi Gupta only one answer? So type it in the same message, okay? So that will be easier. Sir, are the questions going to be in a sequential order? Oh, definitely, questions will be in sequence. Even the audio also will be in sequence, okay? So don't worry about it. Listening, they won't confuse you. The leniency will be there, okay? So don't worry. Just concentrate on what they're speaking and on the question where you have to actually answer. If you are there, that will, you know, do wonders. You can get a great score, okay? Okay, so let's discuss the answers now. First one is, what aspect of the flight does the man complain about? The answer is C, temperature. So C is the right answer, C as in cat. Okay, so he says, I'm punctual, I even ordered for more leg room. This is all, you know, the thing. But what did he complain about? That is the question all about. See, the audio, they purposely want you to, you know, go into a different direction. But the question is what? What does the man complain about? He never complained about punctuality. Why? If he's not punctual, obviously the airline won't allow him, right? That's a different thing. So punctuality is gone. And legroom, definitely he wanted a legroom and he got it. So that's fine. But the air condition was not working. So definitely he was suffocating. Isn't it? So temperature is the right answer. Okay. Next. Second, what does the man think about the food served during the flight? And for this question, I remember when I was traveling from Maldives through Sri Lanka Airlines, I got a, you know, nice snack where they had, you know, fish rice kind of thing. They had a little fish, a small fish, a tuna fish, I believe. Very delicious. And with that, a scoop of rice. So it was a very small portion and it is very tasty. I wanted it for the second time, but I couldn't ask because I was boarding the airlines for the first time. So whenever I come across this question, I remember that sequence. So the answer here is not enough to eat. A, it is not enough to eat. So second answer is A as an alpha. Okay. Not enough to eat. That's what he says. It's just like a snack, very small portion, right? Yes, because it is not bad in taste, because it is exactly opposite. He said it is good in taste, even not inexpensive. He says inexpensive. Inexpensive means what? It is not so expensive. Some people have given for the second question B. So B is wrong. It is not expensive. He says inexpensive. Inexpensive means not so expensive. So the only option which we need to tick here is A. It is very small portion, that is not enough to eat. Some of you have given the answer for the second one as B. I'll repeat that part of audio. Okay, listen to it carefully.
I do apologize for this fault with the air conditioning. Now, while I have you on the phone, would you mind answering a short questionnaire regarding your recent flight?
Sure.
Okay, let's get started. What did you think of the food that was served to you during the flight?
I thought that it was inexpensive and quite delicious. However, I was still very hungry afterwards.
So, inexpensive. I hope you all got it now, right? Those who got the second answer as B, which is wrong, now you got it. Now it's A, isn't it? Can you type yes or no, guys? Okay, let's go to the third one. Third answer is, what does the man think about the service of the staff? Obviously, he said that it's a long wait, bad attitude, no? Even he's satisfied, but he has to wait, you know, for the thing, okay? So, B, third one is B, B as in boy, okay? Long wait, or B as in bravo, whatever it is, okay? So, third one is B. Let's go to the next question. Any doubts here? Shall we go to the next question? Okay. So, these are called MCQs. So, MCQs, you know, they'll confuse you in this way. You feel that at one point of time, everything is uttered. But the speakers only mean, according to the question, they mean something else. Okay. So, you need to listen to the speaker carefully and also read the question carefully. Then only you'll be able to get the right answer. I hope by now you got it. So MCQs are a little tough. So that is the reason we started with a tougher exercise. Okay? Yes. Let's go to the next question type, which is again matchings. Okay, we'll do this matching. Okay? I think we have 2 to 3 minutes left. We can go on this. Okay. Let's see what else we can do from here. Yeah, we'll do this. Yes, okay. Matchings. Matchings is what, again, you need to choose from the above options. You need to choose only 4 options. For example, here we have A, B, C, D, like that, G. Total G options we have, right? So, but you need to only choose one. So let's see what would be the answer.
Here on Radio Philly, we have Jessica Meadows, one of the artistic directors from our own Selma Theater. Hello, Jessica.
Hello.
Now, you are here to tell us about your upcoming production of the play, Is God Is. Is that correct? Well, yes. But I just want to clarify up front that this will not be your typical play. In fact, it will be a radio play. With the pandemic making it impossible to have people come watch the play in person and to get the actors together to film the play, we decided to go with a radio play. Hi, Steve. So tell us a little bit about the obstacle or process of converting a play written for the stage into a play for radio. With this particular play, the challenge was considerable, but by the time we were shut down by the pandemic, we had already put a year of work into the play. For that reason, no one was willing to give up on the show. Everyone wanted to fight to do it somehow. But with this particular play, there is quite a lot of violence. People beating up on one another. As you can imagine, that's hard to do if the actors aren't in the same space. At first, we didn't think this could be recreated via an audio play, but after digging deep and working with experts in sound design and creating original music, we were able to do it. Great! So, mark that on your calendar and be sure to have a quiet place where you can enjoy the audio play. So Jessica, while I have you here, I want to ask about what's next. Can you tell us a bit about how next season will go? Yes and no. We're already working on our plays for next season, which includes four plays that are quite diverse in their subject matter. For example, there is one play about four friends who get together for a backyard party. And there are interesting debates about life. That one's called Heroes of the Fourth Turning.
Okay, now actually the answer started. I'm just helping you with it. Okay, it started from here, the first answer, okay? So I'll just play it from a little further. You can get the first answer, okay?
For example, there is one play about four friends who get together for a backyard party. And there are interesting debates about life. That one's called Heroes of the Fourth Turning.
Okay, so the first answer is B, a drama about friends, because it's about four friends she was talking about, right? So Heroes of Forthcoming is all about four friends. So drama about friends, B is the right answer for the first one. Okay, next.
And there's another play called Minor Character, which is actually a short play translated into six different languages, including a translation produced by a translation app. So very crazy. The final play then is a combination of the six different languages. That sounds interesting indeed. What play are you looking forward the most to? Wow, that's a difficult question. With the first play, it is interesting to see the lives of these characters and how their relationships have formed over the years, though a human drama. But with Minor Character, I am so looking forward to seeing how the director navigates the challenge of working with those different translations. Yes, very different plays for different audiences. So, are tickets already on sale for the upcoming season? Not quite, but we do have the Selma Pass, which is a way to pay now without making a commitment to a particular play or date. You can buy a package of three or four tickets and then use it as you wish. You heard it here first, folks. Support your local theater by purchasing a pass that you can use too.
Okay. So the answers for the first one is I've already given you, which is a drama for the friends. The second answer is set outside, E. First one is B, second is E as an elephant, and third one is different languages, C. And fourth is F, a challenge for the director. So the answers are B, E, C, and F. Okay? Yes. I think most of you have given... Janavi has given, Rohan Gupta has given the right answer. Aina also has given. Ayana, yeah. Varshit also has given. Okay, I'll just play the audio for the one time from where it is to be played. Okay, see, there is a lot of, you know, lag in between. Lag in the sense, obviously, it is required because you need to understand what is this conversation all about. But you need to catch from where you need to answer it. Okay, so that you already know. I'll just play it from there, okay?
original music, we were able to do it. Great. So, listeners, mark that on your calendar and be sure to have a quiet place where you can enjoy the audio play. So, Jessica, while I have you here, I want to ask about what's next. Can you tell me about how next season will go? Yes and no. We're already working on our plays for next season, which includes four plays that are here on Radio Philly. We have Jessica Meadows, one of the artistic directors from our own Selma Theater. Hello, Jessica. Hello. Now, you are here to tell us about your upcoming production of the play, Is God Is. Is that correct? Well, yes, but I just want to clarify up front that this will not be your typical play. In fact, it will be a radio play. With the pandemic making it impossible to have people come watch the play in person and to get the actors together to film the play, we decided to go with a radio play. I see. So tell us a little bit about the obstacles or process of converting a play written for the stage into a play for radio. With this particular play, the challenge was considerable. But by the time we were shut down by the pandemic, we had already put a year of work into the play. For that reason, no one was willing to give up on the show. Everyone wanted to fight to do it somehow. But with this particular play, there is quite a lot of violence. People beating up on one another. As you can imagine, that's hard to do if the actors aren't in the same space. At first, we didn't think this could be recreated via an audio play, but after digging deep and working with experts in sound design and creating original music, we were able to do it. Great. So, listeners, mark that on your calendar and be sure to have a quiet place where you can enjoy the audio play. So, Jessica, while I have you here, I want to ask about what's next. Can you tell us a bit about how next season will go? Yes and no. We're already working on our plays for next season, which includes four plays that are quite diverse in their subject matter. For example, there is one play about four friends who get together for a backyard party, and there are interesting debates about life. That one's called Heroes of the Fourth Turning. And there's another play called Minor Character, which is actually a short play translated into six different languages, including a translation produced by a translation app. So very crazy. The final play then is a combination of the six different languages. That sounds interesting indeed. What play are you looking forward the most to? Wow, that's a difficult question. With the first play, it is interesting to see the lives of these characters and how their relationships have formed over the years. So, a human drama. But with Minor Character, I am so looking forward to seeing how the director navigates the challenge of working with those different translations. Yes, very different plays for different audiences. So, are tickets already on sale for the upcoming season? Not quite, but we do have the Selma Pass, which is a way to pay now without making a commitment to a particular play or date. You can buy a pass.
Okay, so that is the extra she's talking about. So I just cut the extras and, made you hear what exactly to be heard. So if you have any doubts in, what we have done today, you can always go back and check the recording. It will be available by tomorrow, okay, in our website. And also, if you have any doubts about listening, you can always post it now. I'll be able to answer it, okay? And if you don't have any doubts, we'll call it a day. And we'll meet tomorrow. And we'll be discussing on different question types, okay, tomorrow. So we'll be discussing on different question types, like plan diagram, okay? And, we'll also work on summary, all these kind of questions. Okay, so stay tuned, guys. See you tomorrow. And that's all from my end. Any questions? Yes. I want you to type it in the chat box if you have any questions. Any tips and tricks to improve? Yes, Harisinder, the only tip is you need to practice every day. Yes, that is the, you know, only way you can improve listening skills. So because we are hearing, sometimes some people are hearing the native speakers for the first time. No, it is not for the first time. Right? We have been watching a lot of English movies. So watch English movies, watch a lot of English series. Okay, so that will help you. And also do these kind of exercises. Definitely, that will solve your problem. So really, it's difficult to understand the accent of her. Yes, and the accent, you know, sometimes mostly you'll be getting UK-based accent. The reason is it's a Cambridge paper. So it is derived from Cambridge syllabus. Obviously, Cambridge is in UK. So IELTS is from Cambridge. Okay, so definitely you will have, like, at least in every audio, one speaker will be UK person. Okay, so if it's a conversation, sometimes the opposite person can be an US or an Australian. That's a different thing. But to come across this, to get out of this, you know, accent problem, you have to hear it. So once you hear things, definitely that will, there will be no problem. So don't worry. Definitely we can do it tomorrow. So I just got my ears back. Literally, I need to practice a lot, seriously, Charan has said. Okay, no problem. So tomorrow also we'll be practicing. Please come tomorrow at 7:30. Okay, so bye guys. That's all from my end. Sir, how long will be the test score valid? Yeah, so a good question. Ayana is asking how long the test score is valid. It is for 2 years. If you write today, it is valid for 2 years. Okay, so within those 2 years, you can always apply for things. Need to watch Netflix now. Yes, Charan. So watch, mostly watch English movies. English means UK based. Because our speakers are UK based. Okay, so watch BBC channel, BBC news channel. Watch English series, English movies. Like, for example, Harry Potter is made in English. Obviously, you cannot watch all the series. For example, you know, Titanic is an English movie, I think, right? Yeah, UK-based movie, right? Even this Cinderella, this, you know, all the Disney's mostly, okay? Okay, guys, that's all from my end. Thank you and see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Ma'am, you can take over the session.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
All right, guys. So there was one surprise which I had to tell at the end of the session. So firstly, I'm sharing the Telegram channel of IELTS link in the chat box. I've shared it. Do join the Telegram channel of IELTS. And for more information related to various sessions and also the mock test would be available to you there. Also, I have a coupon code, which I'm going to share, using which you can switch over from basic to bronze membership. As I mentioned before, we have three memberships available for you guys at Ubergrad, that is bronze, silver, and gold. So in order to make yourselves available with the bronze membership, there is a coupon code using which you can directly get discount. So this is that coupon code. Yeah, so I've shared the coupon code. You can directly use this particular coupon code and upgrade yourselves from basic membership to the bronze one, in which you will be able to access 4 week IELTS course, 1 AI evaluated IELTS mock, usual university recommendations. We also have free profile evaluation, counselor support, and as I mentioned before, we also have one-on-one IELTS classes just for ₹599 with a whole lot of a whole bag of features and benefits for you all. So you can also avail those directly by sending your details in the chat box, and our team will get into contact with you. So that one-on-one IELTS classes, the benefits that you guys would get are 20 hours live classes, class recordings, daily class worksheets, 10 plus sessional tests, 5 full-length mocks. So these are all the benefits that you will get. So just use this coupon code and upgrade yourself to the bronze membership with some additional facilities and additional benefits. And as I mentioned about the profile evaluation part as well, which is done by our expert speakers, by our experts. So you can directly go on the website of Ubergrad and book your slot according to your preferences, as in your according to your date and your time. You can just book your slots, and if you have any doubts, you can have one-to-one interaction with our experts. So that would be available to you from the website of Ubergrad itself. And also for the recordings, if you have missed anything out, the recordings, the sessional tests, and the handouts are all available on the website of Ubergrad. And for more, as I mentioned, you can upgrade yourselves from basic to bronze. So any other questions, guys, from your side? Any questions from your side? Like any doubts that you guys are facing? All right, great. So thank you so much, guys, for joining. I'll meet you guys tomorrow again for another session on listening, that is session listening session 2. Thank you so much. I'm closing the call for today. The recording of today's session would be uploaded on the website by tomorrow, so you can make yourselves available with that on the website of Ubergrad itself. All right, just a second. I guess there are more questions. All right, so Charan, you can directly contact our team, as in just go to the website over there. You'll get the contact details. Whatever information is there, you can use that. And like, if you have any doubts related to anything, you can just use those contact details that's available to you guys on the website. And also, if you have some more questions, any some more queries related to anything, you can also upgrade yourself to the bronze member and also make yourselves available with the one-on-one sessions. So all your doubts would be clear there. Anything else, guys? All right. Thank you, guys. Now I'm closing the call for today. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much.